After your painting is dry, you can lightly brush off the extra salt and then start coloring in your self-portrait. Use colors that look like you. Now, this part of our project is all about value and texture, which are both elements of design. You can use colored pencils as a great medium to add rich layers of color and shadow to an artwork. You can build them up to look dark and light in different areas. So I start by taking one color and having a light, medium, and dark tone in that one color. You may also use twistable colored pencils and decide where your light source is going to come from in the sky. Wherever your light source is coming from, it will be dark underneath or away from that light source. So I'm starting on this pine tree over here with my lightest color of green, and I'm coloring in where the moonlight might hit. And then I know that pine needles overlap one another. So in that area, there will be a shadow, and I'm using my medium and dark green colored pencil to add a shadow right there. I'm going to do the same thing for the bottom of that pine tree, adding the light green wherever the pine needles stick out so that it looks like the moonlight is hitting it. And then where the pine needles overlap one another, using the darker greens to look like shadow. Value is the lightness or darkness of an image. You'll want to have some dark areas that are in shadow, some light highlighted areas, and then some middle tones to show a wonderful value scale. Adding value helps your artwork to become more realistic and add interest. Also think about the texture of each of your objects, like the pine needles on my pine trees and the building, and you can use the colored pencils to achieve texture, the way something feels. Now I know underneath this eave there's probably a shadow, so I made that part darker, and then underneath that too I'm using the red colored pencil on its side to add even more texture. Lastly, I use a black colored pencil to make the shadows even deeper. So I think about all of the areas that would be facing away from where the moon will be, and I go back in with some black to make the shadows even darker. Our final step is to use oil pastels to add the night sky. So you can do a crescent moon, a full moon, add some stars, maybe a comet. How amazing it is that God made these constellations of stars, and we get to look at them in the night sky and see His amazing creation. You can also use that white oil pastel to add more highlights to the rest of your objects as well. I hope you've had fun creating these self-portraits. In this self-portrait especially, we are imitating God's creation, and the pose that you did on the top of your building really shows you in worship to God and gratitude to Him for how amazing His creation is, and just taking the time to thank Him for it.